The GNOME Foundation has just announced who will be taking the helm at the foundation as the new executive director. So let's meet the new head of the GNOME Foundation. The announcement reads, "The GNOME Foundation is delighted to announce the appointment of Stephen Diebold as our new executive director." I'm sorry if I said that wrong. I think that's how you say it. Diebold steps into a crucial leadership role, and I, for one, am looking forward to what comes from this change. And by the way, Stephen, just real quick, app indicators, also known as system tray menus. Just putting it out there. So who is Stephen Diebold? Well, they say on the announcement that Stephen has been a GNOME user since 2002 and has been involved in numerous free software initiatives throughout his career. His professional background spans technical leadership, cooperative business development, and nonprofit work. His deep roots in open source and business seems to make him a well-equipped person to handle the complexities of GNOME's nonprofit and technical ecosystem. In fact, Diebold is already laying out his goals. He plans to focus on increasing transparency about the people and the process behind GNOME, reestablishing the foundation's financial stability, and building resilience across finances, people, documentation, and processes. A more transparent, financially sound GNOME Foundation means better tools and more stability for users and developers alike. So who wouldn't be on board for that? Accessibility may also get a much needed spotlight. Accessibility matters to everyone. You might not think it does, but it does, because benefiting people who need accessibility features will also benefit others based on the technology that is involved in creating those supports for those features. And that, as a leader who cares about it enough to specifically call it out in his introduction, that is pretty cool. And as Wayland adoption grows and GUI complexity increases, keeping accessibility in the forefront is just fantastic, because it ensures that GNOME remains usable for everyone now and also in the future. So good job there. And a quick thanks to the people who were involved in the beginning, because the guy who kept the foundation afloat in the meantime, the GNOME Foundation says they extend the deepest gratitude to Richard Latour. I probably said that wrong, sorry. Who has served as the interim executive director for the past 10 months. And his behind-the-scenes work brought stability during like a difficult transition time, so that's really good. So thanks, Richard, and thanks for helping like lay the groundwork for Stephen's leadership. And I applied for the position for executive director of GNOME. For those who don't know, I did. And well, the pressure's on, Stephen, because I'll be watching. I'm just kidding. I will be watching because I make a news show, and it's kind of required for me to do that. But good luck. I hope you do well. And oh yeah, did I mention app indicators? If I didn't, app indicators.